the middle toe of the right foot. Chapter 1. It is well known that the old Manton house is haunted. In all the rural district near about, and even in the town of Marshall, a mile away, not one person of unbiased mind entertains a doubt of it. Incredulity is confined to those opinionated persons who will be called cranks as soon as the useful word shall have penetrated the intellectual domain of the Marshall Advance. The evidence that the house is haunted is of two kinds. The testimony of disinterested witnesses, who have had ocular proof, and that of the house itself. The former may be disregarded and ruled out on any of the various grounds of objection which may be urged against it by the ingenious. But facts within the observation of all are material and controlling. In the first place, the Manton house has been unoccupied by mortals for more than 10 years, and with its outbuildings is slowly falling into decay, a circumstance which, in itself, the judicious will hardly venture to ignore. It stands a little way off the loneliest reach of the Marshall and Harriston Road, in an opening which was once a farm, and is still disfigured with strips of rotting fence and half-covered with brambles overrunning a stony and sterile soil, long unacquainted with the plough. The house itself is in tolerably good condition, though badly weather-stained and in dire need of attention from a glazier, the smaller male population of the region having attested in the manner of its kind its disapproval of dwelling without dwellers. It is 2 stories in height, nearly square, its front pierced by a single doorway, flanked on each side by a window boarded up to the very top. Corresponding windows above, not protected, serve to admit light and rain to the rooms of the upper floor. Grass and weeds grow pretty rankly all about, and a few shade trees, somewhat the worse for wind, and leaning all in one direction, seem to be making a concerted effort to run away. In short, as the Marshall Town humorist explained in the columns of the Advance, the proposition that the Manton house is badly haunted is the only logical conclusion from the premises. The fact that in this dwelling Mr. Manton thought it expedient one night some 10 years ago to rise and cut the throats of his wife and 2 small children, removing at once to another part of the country, has no doubt done its share in directing public attention to the fitness of the place for supernatural phenomena. To this house, one summer evening, came 4 men in a wagon. 3 of them promptly alighted, and the one who had been driving hitched the team to the only remaining post of what had been a fence. The 4th remained seated in the wagon. "Come," said one of his companions, approaching him, while the others moved away in the direction of the dwelling. "This is the place." The man addressed did not move.
"By God," he said harshly, "this is a trick, and it looks to me as if you were in it."
"Perhaps I am,"
the other said, looking him straight in the face, and speaking in a tone which had something of contempt in it. "You will remember, however, that the choice of place was with your own assent left to the other side. Of course, if you are afraid of spooks—"
"I am afraid of nothing,"
the man interrupted with another oath, and sprang to the ground. The 2 then joined the others at the door, which one of them had already opened with some difficulty, caused by rust of lock and hinge. All entered. Inside it was dark, but the man who had unlocked the door produced a candle and matches and made a light. Then he unlocked a door on their right as they stood in the passage. This gave them entrance to a large, square room that the candle but dimly lighted. The floor had a thick carpeting of dust, which partly muffled their footfalls. Cobwebs were in the angles of the walls and depended from the ceilings like strips of rotting lace, making undulatory movements in the disturbed air. The room had 2 windows in adjoining sides, but from neither could anything be seen.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.